Howdy, I'm Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. I got a little tip for you with your green beans. I'd start by cutting the ends off of these. If you want, you can just cut them into little pieces. I like to give them a little bias cut. It looks nice. Or you can take and French cut them. Cut them horizontally into long pieces here. Now, if you grow your own green beans, I think it's really, really worth it. Does it taste different? I don't know. It tastes different to me. I think it tastes better. We'll cut them like this here. We'll do another one for you so you can see it real nice. I cut through too early. I'll go ahead and just pick it up again and cut another piece here. Something else you can do is, as you get a little bit better, two at a time. Okay. Once we get them all cut, I put them into a steamer. I think a steamer is the best way to cook green beans. Steam them in here. I can't tell you how many minutes because it just varies. It depends on the green beans, the time of year, how ripe they are. Generally, these will cook in about 5 to 15 minutes. It just depends how long they go here. So we'll let these steam, and we're going to come back. We're going to make an Italian-style green bean with pancetta and some nice seared steaks. Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. Today, green beans. I've got some beautiful green beans here. So we're going to set these aside for a moment. You can do that hours ahead or the day before if you want to save time when you're cooking. So we're going to start here. Let's get some steaks going here. I've got some filet mignon. Did you see the marbling in these steaks? It's just incredible. The fine lines of fat in there. You also see how they're a little bit dark? We age our steaks for 3 to 4 weeks. These are incredible filets. All local, of course. Colorado. We're lucky to have some of the best beef in the world right here in Colorado. So I start with a little drizzle of olive oil. I've got my pan preheated. I also preheated the oven to about 350 degrees. Now I like to put a fair amount of this seasoning on here. This is my Tuscan grill. And this is a nice seasoning because I don't over salt it. I use nice big chunks of salt, but not too much salt. So you can get a good ratio of herbs and even garlic if you want to add a little garlic to it. So we're going to put those into the pan. And then I'll season the other side. All right. So we're going to sear these probably about 3 minutes, turn 45 degrees, about 3 more minutes. Hopefully we'll get the nice little crosshatch pattern. Then we're going to turn them over and stick them in the oven to finish. It's a much more forgiving way to do. All right, so we got these brown, a nice little hatch mark pattern on them there. Brown them about, it was probably about 6-7 minutes we had these cooking. Turned them over, now they're gonna go in the oven. This is a great way to go. You don't have to worry about burning them too much on the outside before they get done in the middle. You could also just put these on the grill. Okay, they've been in the oven for about 8 minutes or so. Let's take them out. Looking just right. Generally, what you want to do is pull the steaks off a little lower than the finished temperature you like, because after you take them off, they're going to continue cooking. Here we go. I want to let them sit there and rest for about 10 minutes before I slice them. So this is the perfect time to start our green beans. Take a little bit of oil in our pan, and I'm going to add a little bit of bacon. Now, you could use regular bacon. I'm using Italian pancetta. You could use a regular classic bacon like this. You could use a smoky bacon. You could use a maple-y bacon. A peppered bacon would also be really, really nice. But just pick out the one you like, and you can change the style around. So I'm going to cook this bacon, and we're going to saute this until it's about as brown as you want and take it out. I'm going to take the bacon out. I got it nice and brown as you like it. It could be soft, or I got this pancetta a little bit crisp. Just right there. And that left behind some nice, tasty oil. I'm going to throw the garlic into that oil and some onions. I'm going to saute those for probably 3-4 minutes. So they start getting soft, a little bit brown, soft, and sweet. All right, these have been sauteing for 5-6 minutes. Nice little color to them. You like that. I'm going to go ahead and add some green beans to this. And we're basically just going to rewarm them and toast them a little bit with this nice oil that came from the pancetta. And you got the flavor of the onion and the garlic in there. This is really delicious. I'm also going to give this a pinch of the same, the Tuscan grill rub. Pretty good season. You can use it just for about everything. Okay, that's almost done. For the side dish, I prepared a little tomato salad. Very, very simple. I just sliced some tomatoes. I went ahead and put some olives on the top here, and I'm gonna finish it with some Parmesan cheese. You wanna make sure you use Reggiano Parmigiano. That's the only true Parmesan cheese. And the flavor is, it's just worth it. It's so much better. Okay, that is ready to go. Here we go. Yes, and we had our filet mignon and had a chance to rest. We're gonna finish it up here with a little bit of the pancetta. Nice crisp fried pancetta. We'll finish this with a little sweet balsamico di Modena. This is magic sauce. I love this stuff. It's balsamic vinegar is one thing. See how thick it is? It takes a while. This is a 8-year aged balsamic vinegar. It's been reduced way down from the wine grapes. Flavor's fabulous. So we've got it together here. We've got a beautiful Tuscan steak with Italian style green beans made with pancetta and a tomato salad. You can get this recipe and all the recipes we did today at digincolorado.com. Let's dig in.